Hey everyone, I hope you guys are doing really well. So I really wanted to build a sort of a beach house villa type thing in The Sims 4. So we are in the map Zone Solani and I found this, the plot actually already had a house on it, which I just completely demolished. But for me, it was the best kind of place for this house type thing because it's kind of out of the way and you're not really overlooked at all, and that worked out perfectly for what I end up actually doing this villa for. Normally with my builds, I never have like an exact layout idea of what I want to do. I just kind of start building and then come up with ideas from then, which is nice but also really annoying, which comes to me like changing my mind umpteen times about what I want where and all that kind of stuff. So this build actually does end up being a sort of resort is the wrong word, I keep going to say resort, but it's more like a villa, like honeymoon villa, getaway villa, that type of thing. I think I was gearing this more towards kind of like honeymoon villa. It's very open plan, a very simple kind of like you've just gone to like your villa, hotel room, whatever. It's very clean and stuff like that. So it's just got the one bedroom and it's got a really like the upstairs of this one. It's very open, really large windows, nothing is like super closed off. It's all got like loads of space and everything like that, and lots of views of the ocean, mainly just like the deck space. And then I do put some towels and stuff more towards the front of the villa. I am proud of how I actually managed to do the roof on this one. Roofing is really not a strong point of mine and I struggle with it so much. So I just try and normally go for like the simplest of things. This roof I quite liked. I thought it was just like, it was alright and it fit the purpose. I don't normally see a lot of, I normally struggle with the roof more if I'm like doing a diagonal wall, and I really like to use diagonal walls. I really just like to have like houses with like weird shapes, kind of thing, rather than just using like squares and stuff like that. I really like to use the diagonals a fair bit, so I think that's why sometimes I do struggle with the whole roofing type thing as well. But even just when I use a square and I want to have like some funky roofing rather than just like one large piece, I still seem to struggle. So the stairs, I actually cut a little bit. I was messing with the stairs so much. I couldn't get them to fit in how I wanted, but inevitably, again, it was kind of simple how like they would fit. So the upstairs, you can see at the moment, it's just literally a bed, a huge kind of archway with some curtains on it for a little bit of privacy, because the bathroom that I decided to do for this is because it's just like a honeymoon kind of like getaway thing for a couple, this, that and the other. I was thinking of an open bathroom, and I've never done an open bathroom in The Sims 4 before, so I thought that now is the time to try it. So I do end up going for a open bathroom look, and I actually really love it. I think it looks awesome and totally fits the vibe that I was going for. So it does have kind of like a separate toilet, but the toilet, the way that you get in is just like, it's just like an archway, like an arch door, so you might want to tell your partner to not come up if like in the bathroom or stuff like that. But the kind of open bathroom, I wanted just a bath in there, and then I have put in a shower, like outside shower, on the deck, like downstairs area, but I was thinking that's more for just I don't know, washing off seawater or something like that. You can always swap out the bathtub for a shower and maybe make it kind of like a little wet room area, if you will. That would also be really cool. But I absolutely really like how the upstairs of this one turned out, and I think it just looks pretty cool. So behind the bath and that, I just put in some mirrors and stuff, kind of like, I was trying to think of like the most honeymoonish vibe type thing to go for, and this is just what I kind of come up with. So yeah, it's definitely a cute place to download if you want to send your Sims on a cute little honeymoon getaway type thing after they just got married and this, that and the other. I really like it. The kitchen, the downstairs area is actually kind of simple as well. I just use the sliding doors with the like grates in them. I don't know the name for them, but they're like the windows I've used in the bedroom, but it's the door version. I think that they're cool for the front of the property, just to give it maybe like a little bit more privacy. And then the back, back doors leading out onto the deck is the glass ones, and they're a lot more open and stuff like that, which I really, really quite like. I think that it looks super awesome, and I am really happy with it, so I can only hope that you guys like it as well. The living room, dining room area, I didn't put in a dining table like inside the house, but I have put a dining room table outside on the deck just in front of the glass sliding doors, because I thought it would be nice and like romantic in the evening for your Sims to have like dinner out there on the deck and stuff like that, which I think is super cute and stuff. I do have a couple of screenshots of my Sims at the end. Just like chilling out and stuff like that. I should really do like some videos and stuff of that incorporated into the videos, like speed builds, because I think that would be really cute as well. But yeah, the kitchen, it's just really open plan. You've got like a small sofa with a TV, stuff like that. You want to watch TV, this, that, and the other. A small kind of island area with an oven, a sink, just some like bar stools, like counter bar stool type thing where they can sit and eat, and then obviously you've got like the big table outside on the deck. The fridge is kind of like tucked away in the corner, which I thought was a good addition. I do mess about with the furniture a lot, so you'll be seeing me trying to fit in different things and see what I like. But yeah, I'm really happy with the end result and stuff like that, so I can only hope that you guys enjoy this video. As always, I will use hashtag TagJelly in any of the builds that I do, so feel free to follow me over on the gallery or just download any of my builds if you fancy what they look like. And if you want to change them up, obviously it's more than welcome. You don't have to keep them exactly the same. I just like to share them around. So yeah, I'm not really sure what else to say, so just thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really, really hope that you enjoyed this build. Please let me know what you thought about it in the comments down below. Let me know if you have any ideas or anything like that. I'm always open to suggestions, so just thank you all so much, and hit the like button. Do not forget to subscribe if you are new, and I will see you all in the next video. Take care. Bye.